Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So, in this video, I want to showcase the global version of Yauras and Zain. Yep, okay, so once again, this is not my account. This account provided by Gumi, and basically I can only use this account for unit reviews. I cannot use this for arena, multiplayer, chat, summon, and many other stuff. Basically only for unit reviews, and this is not my account. Okay, so this is Yauras, the status. At level 85, full enchant, and then with her weapon and alchemono. Okay, maybe I should remove alchemono. So this is her stats without alchemono. Yeah, only her weapon. The agility, yeah, it's only 149. If you equip her with Dorama, Battlefield Dorama, it will be 160, I think. Yeah, but it is still lower compared to the one I showcased in Japan version last time, because of it is still the normal Twin Blade Knight. Yeah, the one I showcased in Japan, it was Twin Blade Knight Plus, and the martial artist was already Holy Brawler. So basically, she is an evasion unit. Yeah, she has perfect evasion. You can also try to give her the Twin Blade Knight's reaction skill, which is chance of performing a PMT strike when receiving a physical attack. Both of these are good, but yeah, it is up to you. Sometimes evasion is better, sometimes preemptive attack is better. If you want to kill the enemies faster, then this one is better for the preemptive counterattack. This one is a must use, I think. Evasion and move plus one. Move plus one is really good. Now, she has move 4 thanks to this. Yeah. And for the second passive, you can either use toughness or feint. Actually, toughness only gives her additional 60 max HP, which is, you know, actually not really that significant, but yeah, it is up to you. You want extra evasion or toughness? And for the basic, you can use basic combat for charge up and then use her most damaging skill. This one will get upgraded later into, you know, 5 range, and that's really good. Yeah. Okay, so that's basically about her stats and abilities overall. Now Zain. Well, this account doesn't have any sword, so this is the best attack boosting gear that I can equip to him. P attack plus 30. And this is the stats. He can reach P attack 500 easily. Yep. If you equip him with Katanova's sword, P attack plus 50. Even at level 75, you can already reach P attack 500, I think. If it's without any gear, the P attack is 470 at level 50. The max HP without any gear, 720. So if you equip him with Alchemono, the max HP will be 932, which is quite decent. Still not as high as, you know, the other tanks like Monzain, but it is already quite decent, yeah, quite okay to use because of Zain has Divine Shelter, All Elemental Rest, minus 15%, and then Holy Nut Sun Shu, chance of defending when receiving damage. So he is tough, and also has a nice agility as a tank. If you equip him with Battlefleet Dorama, I think the agility can go to 118 or 119. If it's in Japan, using the Holy Cavalier gear job, his agility can go to 149, which is very high for a tank. Yeah, in the future, he will be more powerful. Not as the Lord Commander, but as Holy Cavalier. The enchant job, Holy Cavalier gear. He is very powerful in the future. Lord Commander is still very good job though. Okay, so Lord Commander, actually it has all elements except water. See, light, thunder, fire, and from the basic, this one is dark, and this one is wind. Yeah, this one is supposed to be dark. So yeah, he has all elements except water, which means he is also a kinda, you know, the better version of magic sword man, because some of his attacks are magic damage, like this one, Shining Flare. This is the AoE 5-5 diamonds. The other setup is to use the basic magic blade if you want to access the water element, but basic sun blade is already good enough. So for the setup, I think it is recommended to use this setup if you want more damage, because it gives slash attack. If you want to make him tougher, you can give him Guardian. The PDEF will be 396. If you want to deal more damage, you can use this. So first of all, let's showcase Yauras, her skills one by one in this video. So her Reader skill is P attack 50% for water units, and yeah, her damage will be very good in this damage showcasing clip. Okay, so this is her normal attack damage, 873. Let's remember this number, 873. And to fire enemy, it is 1098. The first skill damage, it will boost P attack for 3 turns. And the damage is like this. Okay, anyway, let's use it to this fire enemy. Attack up. And the normal attack damage now 992, so the damage boost, it was around 15%. The second skill raises evasion rate of ally units within target area for 3 turns. The AoE is like this, so it is a very good skill. I mean, if you are using her in PvE versus monsters, you can use this to raise her evasion skills. And then the third skill, Shiny Bubbles, 3 hits combo. The range is 3. The damage to this enemy is 1104. To this enemy, it is 160%, yeah, because, you know, the damage boost to weaker element is added. And once again, it has a chance to critical. That's the awesome part of her skills. And the final skill, Twin Blossom Fury, 4 hits, chance critical, increased damage when attacking from side, and increased damage when attacking from behind. If it's to water enemy, 1096. To fire enemy, 1656. So this one is still better actually, Shiny Bubbles. But if you use this from behind, you will get extra damage. 1100. Only 4 extra damage, what the hell? Okay, anyway, let's use this. Twin Blossom Flurry to the fire enemy. Okay, the one from basic ability. Physical damage and charm. So she can also do charm, which is nice. Raises own P attack for 3 turns. Let's see the P attack boost. It is now 992, so it is supposed to be quite similar to the, you know, main abilities for skill, which is the damage boost. It's supposed to be at around plus 15%. Not bad at all. And smooth progress raises on agility and move plus 1 for 3 turns. This will make her move 5. Yeah, 5 tiles for 3 turns. So she can be very, very agile in the map. Very, very good. And then the last skill, physical damage and daze. Range 3, area 1 square line. So I can use it like this. So let's use it to the fire enemy. It is 1600 to the fire enemy. So now let's showcase Zain. P attack 50% leader skill. So his damage will be very high. I equip Gilgamesh gear to this Zain. So his attack is 500, and he also got the damage boost from the slash damage boost. Okay, so his normal attack damage is 1197. Definitely higher than Yauras' normal attack, which is awesome, right? Divine Blade. Light physical damage low and raises own slash attack for 3 turns. Let's see the slash attack boost. Okay, the damage is nice. Now, the normal attack damage is 1401. Wow, so the damage boost is around 20%. Now, lightning bolt. Long range thunder magic damage on a single target. Although it is a magic damage, it is actually affected by his P attack too, so both P attack and magic attack. The damage to fire enemy 1505, and if it's on water enemy 1825. This is very good damage. Now Shining Flare, inflict fire magic damage on enemy units within target area, range 3, 5-5 diamonds. It is like this AoE. Win enemy, 1971. That's a high damage. Now, the bottom skill, Supernova. At level 85, he can immediately use this. Yep, light physical damage on enemy units within target area, range 2, area lateral 3, hate range 2. So here it is. Basic Sunblade. Raise his own max HP for 5 turns. His max HP now 752. If I use this. It is now 977. Okay, that's a really nice max HP boost. Knight of Avalon, recover HP of ally units within target area, around self. The AoE is like this, the HP here is 303, that's really nice. Okay, 300 HP heal in global is really nice because of the max HP in global. It's not that high, most units only have around 400-600 max HP. Holy Jail, inflict physical damage low with chance of inflicting petrify, range 1. Okay, so here it is the skill. Okay. The petrify chance is not that high actually, but still, it is petrify. The last skill, Grand Blast, from the basic ability, inflict wind magic damage on enemy units within target area. The AoE is like this. So as for the summary, Yauras is kinda like the water element version of Bolt, rather Yomi, Ryle. Yeah, high agility, high evasion. Well, you know, Saber Lamia is kinda similar to this Yauras actually. High agility, has evasion, and a pretty nice damage too. So she is the second water unit that has, you know, high agility and high evasion and nice damage too. And nice appearance too. Yeah, I really like the design of this Yauras. Yeah, basically she is strong and cute. And then Zain, it's a tank that has high damage, so you can imagine a Fatale that can do a lot more damage. That is Zain. Yeah, the drawback compared to Fatale. Fatale is fire, right? Fatale is super strong against wind enemies, but Zain, as a light element, basically he will take more damage from dark enemy and he will do more damage to dark enemy. So he doesn't have something like, you know, being the stronger element like Fatale against wind element. Yeah, that's the drawback of Zain. But the pro is the enemy cannot counter his element. Yeah, that's a cool part of Zain. He is tough and also can do very high damage. And speaking of how good Zain and Yauras now in Japan, they are still super good. Yeah, still very very good. So they have long lifespan. If you want to invest your shards on them, it is up to you. You can invest your shards, or if you are patient enough, you know, since the Sacred Memories collaboration will come like quite often in the future, eventually, even as free player, you might be able to get them to level 75 without spending any shards if you are patient enough, okay? Yep, because there will be a lot 500 gem summon for these characters, I mean Zain and Yauras, in the future. If you're lucky enough, you will be able to get multiple Zains and Yauras. And as for now in Japan, my Zain is already level 85. Yep. I think I didn't spend any life shards on him. Or actually I did. Maybe I didn't, yeah. And he is level 85 right now. I got multiple of him from the, you know, daily free summon in Japan. Lastly, if you are asking, are they worth to summon, are they worth to do until step 3? My answer is yes. Yep, you will get either Zain and Yauras on the sub-tree, right? So, since both of them are good, both are jackpots. Yep, basically. If you get Yauras, it's okay, she is good here. You still can get your Zain later in the future, and on the future mission challenge, you can get Zain for free actually. But still, you need to limit break him, right? So, it is actually okay to summon him right from now. Even though, you can get one Zain for free later on the mission challenge. So even free players can have Zain. So yep, I think that's all for now guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe if you haven't. And see you again next time. Bye bye. The Alchemist Code Global Punch.